Welcome and good morning to all my dear students. I am Professor G.B. Shenge. Next, see the next exercise of our course. The course number is Agro 3612. Now see the exercise number 4 and exercise number 5. The title of this exercise is Generate Spectral Profiles of Different Objects. And exercise number 5, that is the supervised and unsupervised classification and acreage estimation. Okay. Now, first see the exercise number 4. Title of this exercise is Generation of Spectral Profiles of Different Objects. In this exercise, first see the what is meant by spectral profile or meaning of spectral profile. The spectral profile, it is the multi-spectral imagery which includes the lots of images. It is a powerful tool for distinguish different types of materials and features in the landscape. Okay, it's the powerful tools. In this tools or in this profile, the different material and features are distinguished which is available on the landscape. Okay, for example, the material and features like buildings, trees, animals, okay, these are the different material and features is distinguished in the spectral profile. The natural and man-made material, the natural material like trees, animals, birds, and man-made material like buildings, roads, etc. These materials often have its unique spectral signatures that can be used to identify them quantitatively. The spectral profile charts allow you to select the areas of interest. First, you have to select the areas of interest or a object for the spectral profile or ground features on the images and review the spectral information of all bands in a chart formats. A spectral profile which consists the geometry which is related to the earth information to define the pixel selection and an image with key metadata from which to sample. Okay, what is mean by pixel? In last lecture we have already seen the what is pixel. Okay, this is the meaning of spectral profile. Next, see the how to generate the spectral profile. Okay, how to generate the spectral profile? The spectral profile which creates a chart by using the spectral profile, you have to create the chart by using the different softwares like right click the layer you want to analyze in the content plane, point to create a chart and click spectral profile to open the chart properties on pane. To define the parameter settings for your chart, click the data tab at the top of the chart, the properties pane. The spectral profile is generated by using the three steps. The name of the first step, that is to define an area of interest for your spectral profile. Okay, you have to define or select the area of interest or object for your spectral profile. Okay, for example, you have to select the tree for the spectral profile. Okay, in this step there are several options for defining the set of pixels you want to profile. Okay, you can use the define an area of interest tools at the top of the chart properties pane to delineate an area or features of interest in the map view. In these steps, the pixel values of that image bands that interest the area of interest will be plotted. The area of interest sketch tools includes a point, line, circles, rectangular, polygon, triangle. Okay, these are the polygon features layer in the map. View that overlay on the images. If you have segmented image layer in the contents pane, you can select a segment as your area of interest. Okay, or use the drop down arrow next to the segment icon to select the segmented image you want to use. Okay, or use the color picker to choose a color when defining your area of interest. The color is available on that chart. Use different colors for various features you want to compare with your spectral profile. Okay, this is the first step for spectral profile. Then second step, that is to define your spectral profile. First you have to select object for the spectral profile, then second define your spectral profile. Okay, information which is related to that object. Each area of interest you collect is listed in a table under the spectral profile and is given default label or give the name for this spectral profile, such as profile 1, profile 2, profile 3, profile 4, and so on as they are collected. To assign your own labels, select the labels for an area of interest, type a new string and press the tab key to register the string labels are stored as you type them, then making available in the pick list for reuse. You can choose the different colors for any of the areas of interest by clicking the color box and selecting the color from the cooler picker. Okay, when the spectral profile is defined using a collection of pixels, the default visualization is a line chart. You can also choose to display the spectral profiles as another plot type. Okay, the best plot type for the spectral profile defined with a point is the main line options, because of range of values is not available in. And after that, you can create a spectral profile of a single band image, but the mean line option for plot type will be unavailable. The spectral plot of a single band image displays the useful information such as a minimum, maximum, medium and quartile values. Okay, this is the second step, that is you have to define the spectral profile. Then after that, the third step, that is the label your chart. Okay, after defining the spectral profile, you have to label your chart. Click the general tab at the top of the chart properties pane. Okay, on the above or top of the chart properties, you have to click on the general tab. After that, specify a title of your chart. Okay, and you have to mention the title of your chart, legend, and label your axis, like x axis and y axis. And you can add a detailed description of your spectral profile chart. Okay, in the label your chart, you have to detail mention the type of chart, name of that chart on the x axis or on the y axis. Okay, this is the third step, that is label your chart. Okay, this is the whole informations about exercise number 4. The title of this exercise is generation of spectral profiles of different objects. Okay, spectral profile means it is a multispectral imagery. It is a powerful tool for distinguishing different types of materials and features in the landscape, that is called a spectral profile. And how to generate the spectral profile? It includes the three steps. First step, that is define an area of interest for your spectral profile. First, you have to select the object, that is for the spectral profile. Then second step, that is define your spectral profile, okay, or mention the name of that spectral profile, that is profile 1, profile 2, okay, and third, that is label your chart. Okay, this is the three steps which includes the spectral profile. Then next is the exercise number 5. Title of this exercise is supervised and unsupervised classification and acreage estimation. First, see the what is a supervised classification or meaning of supervised classification. Try to understand the meaning of a supervised classification. It is a based supervised classification is based on the idea that a user can select the sample pixels is an image that are representative of specific classes and then direct the image processing software to use these training sites as a reference for the classification of all the other pixels in the image, that is called a supervisor classification. In the supervisor classification, individual organism or individual plant or individual tree studied under the supervisor classification. In the unsupervised classification, group of trees, group of birds, okay, studied, homogeneous groups which are studied under the unsupervised classification. The supervisor classification can be defined normally as the process of sample to know the identity to classify pixels of unknown identity. Okay, it is defined normally for the process of samples to know the identity of that object or classify the pixels of unknown identity. Okay, also the user also set the bounds for how similar other pixels must be grouped them together. These bounds are often set based on the spectral characteristics of the training area plus or minus a certain increment or strength of reflection in specific spectral bands. Okay. In the supervisor classification, the sample of known identity are those samples or those pixels located within a training area. The pixels located within these areas term the training samples used to guide the classification. To guide the classifications or algorithm to assigning the specific spectral values of appropriate informational class. There is a supervised classification, and unsupervised classification means it is a unsupervised classification is where the outcomes, that is the grouping of pixels with common characteristics. Okay, study of homogeneous materials, that is in the group, that is group of trees, group of mango trees. Okay, homogeneous material, that is called as unsupervised classifications. These classifications are based on the software analysis of an image without the user providing the classes. The computer uses techniques to determine which pixels are related and group them into the classes. The user can specify which algorithm the software will use and the desired number of outputs classes, but otherwise does not aid in the classification process. However, the user must have knowledge of the area being classified when the grouping of pixels with common characteristics produced by the computer have to relate to actual features on the ground, like the features like such as a wetlands, okay, developed areas, coniferous forest, etc., which is included under the unsupervised classification. Then see the advantages and disadvantages of supervised and unsupervised classification. The advantages of unsupervised classification relative to supervised classification can be enumerated as follows. The first, that is no extensive prior knowledge of the region is required. Okay, this classification is very cheap. No extensive, but it required the technical or prior knowledge before using. Okay, the opportunity for human error is minimized. In this classification, the human error is minimized. Unique classes are recognized as a distinct units. And disadvantages, like it arises primarily from a reliance on a natural grouping and difficulties in matching these groups to the informational categories that are interest to the analyst. In the unsupervised classification, identifies spectrally the homogeneous classes. In the unsupervised classification, homogeneous material is required in grouping form within the data. These classes do not necessarily correspond to the informational categories that are of interest to analyst. And third one is spectral properties of specific information classes will change over time on the basis of seasonal as well as over the year. As a result, relationship between informational classes and spectral classes are not constant, and relationship defined for one image can seldom be extended to others images. Okay, these are the different disadvantages and advantages and disadvantages of classifications. The next point, that is the acreage estimations. Okay, estimation of acreage. The basic the meaning of acreage estimation, or what is meant by acreage estimation, the approach taken for acreage estimation was to determine the proportional distribution of the crops in the sampled segment over the agriculture areas and apply this proportion to the agricultural land area from the classification. By using this classification, supervised and unsupervised, you have to calculate the acreage under the agricultural crops, that is called as acreage estimation. The objective of acreage estimation is the crop acreage and production estimation is of great challenge and requires strategic decision to be taken by government agencies, which is regarding to controlling the import and export duties and also to control the inflation as a whole. Okay, acreage estimation is used when the material is import or export. Okay, then applications or improvement in the acreage estimations, it can be used by government agencies. The acreage estimation is used by the government agencies for taking decisions regarding import and export duty control and by agencies interested in procurement of crops can be used by government agencies like RBI, Reserve Bank of India to tackle the inflation as well. Okay. This estimation is used by the government agencies for taking the decisions which is related to the import and export duty control. And this agency is interested in procurement of crops and can be used by the RBI for tackle the inflation as well. This is the acreage estimation. Okay. This is the exercise number 5. Supervised and unsupervised classification, advantages and disadvantages and meaning of acreage estimation. Okay. Thank you.